Hello, this is Dr. Damon Miller, your Organic MD.
And this is Carlisle Koash. Welcome to the Organic MD podcast. Actually, this is a video cast, as we have a bit of an enhanced talk and some images and slides and things like that. So welcome.
And today we're going to be doing the first of at least three of these short talks on Stargardt disease. Stargardt disease is a degenerative eye disease, a retinopathy, maculopathy. It's one of the diseases we work a lot with because we have some great things to do for them. We're going to be starting this with a talk about the genetics of Stargardt disease. And we're starting there because the next one we're going to do is about some of the research that's being done about Stargardt disease. And the third talk that we have planned is about the treatments for Stargardt disease. Stargardt is, it's spelled S-T-A-R-G-A-R-D-T, sometimes referred to as juvenile macular degeneration. It's a disease that looks a lot like macular degeneration, but tends to show up earlier in life than macular degeneration, which is often referred to as an age-related disease.
Like usually, what age does it show up?
Well, that's one of the things we're going to be talking about. Typically, it can show up in teenagers. People often report that they first knew there was something wrong with their vision when they were a teenager. It's become more complex because I've had people who were in their late 40s, early 50s, who were diagnosed as Stargardt disease. And one of the things that I think is going on here is that things are getting a little complex in that there are people who, when you do some genetic testing on them, it looks more like they really have just macular degeneration, but they're showing up at a very young age. And conversely, I think there are people who have been taking very, very good care of their health who make it to their 40s or 50s before they have any problems with their eyes. But it is truly Stargardt disease.
So these are one of the diseases that you can get a genetic test for?
Or? Oh, that's a good question. You can. I mean, it's a little complex because there was an article. There are actually journals devoted to the genetics of diseases in ophthalmology. There's one that's called Ophthalmologic Genetics and several others. But there was an article which was titled Genetics Unite, What Ophthalmologists Divide. And so the whole point of that was that there is one gene that carries these abnormalities for a lot of these different diseases. So you have Stargardt disease, where the retina has this peculiar look. You've got macular degeneration, which shows up later, but it still involves central vision loss. You've got other diseases like retinitis pigmentosa, which involve electrical abnormalities when you test the eye, and they involve peripheral vision loss. And yet the gene that's abnormal in these, it's all the same gene. And why you have one person has an abnormality on this gene and it looks like one disease, and another person has another abnormality and it looks like a different disease, it's not clear at all. So the truth is, though, that all of these degenerative retinopathies, degenerative maculopathies, they're a lot more similar than they are different. But you can get a test, although I don't really recommend it for people.
Why is that?
Well, there's really two parts of your genetics. There's the genome. A genetic test measures what is your DNA sequence. So the genetic information is carried in the sequence of base pairs in your DNA. But there's a whole new field, and actually one of the most exciting fields in medicine right now is called epigenetics. Epi meaning the information that sits on top of the genetic material. So all of these genes, your DNA is wrapped up in all of these proteins and histones and all these things that influence whether or not a segment of a gene gets expressed or suppressed. And that epigenetic material, all of that material that's coded for by these proteins that wrap up the DNA, that really is the important information that tells you whether a gene is going to get expressed or not. And one of the reasons I discourage a lot of people from getting genetic testing is that people tend to believe that their genes are their destiny, and they're not. Your genes are not your destiny. And, you know, it just tends to promulgate and promote fear. You get a genetic test and it says, oh, you have the gene for diabetes, or you have the gene for breast cancer, you have the gene for Stargardt or macular degeneration or one of these things, and people think, oh, I'm doomed. You know, I'm just screwed. I'm going to have no vision when I get older. And the truth is, these genes are, they have what's called a high penetrance in the culture, meaning they're very common. A lot of people have these genes. You know, typically these diseases were thought of as diseases of Scandinavians, you know, fair-haired, light-skinned people that, you know, migrated to this country. But, you know, I've treated people from the Indian subcontinent. I've treated people from South Africa, from West Africa. I've treated people from all over Asia and East Asia. I've treated people from South America. These diseases are everywhere. And the reason there's such a high penetrance is that you think about it, especially macular degeneration, there's nothing to discourage that gene. In other words, you live through your reproductive years. You never have any problems with your health, your eyes, or anything else. There's nothing to select against your having lots of babies and things like this. And it's only much later in life that you realize, oh, I've got an eye problem. Mm-hmm. And typically, the way the genetics for Stargardt are thought of is that you have a copy of the gene that's abnormal from two different parents. Whereas in old garden variety macular degeneration, you just have one copy of the gene from one of your parents. But that's not holding up. There are a lot of people who are in their 40s and 50s. They're diagnosed with Stargardt's because the definition of Stargardt's is it's a juvenile or an early onset disease. So if you have something that looks like central vision loss, a degenerative maculopathy, retinopathy, and you're 40 or 50 years old, you get labeled as Stargardt disease. But it could just be, you know, that we live in such a lousy world now that diseases that used to only show up in your 60s and 70s are showing up in your 40s and 50s.
So someone who might have this gene, you know, how worried do they need to be? I mean, it sounds like maybe a little bit, but maybe not as much as they would think necessarily.
Well, in the later cast that we're going to do where we talk about this, and there's material on organicmd.com, and we just wrote a book, Stem Cells Heal Your Eyes. You can find that on Amazon. That's by Damon Miller, me, and Carlisle Koash. But there's a lot you can do not only to treat these diseases if you have them, there's a whole lot you can do to prevent them. Basic things that you do to take care of the health of your eyes so that you live a long and happy life and go to your grave with good eyesight. And that's really the focus here of what we're doing at Organic MD and Better Eye Health is we're trying to let people know that your genes are not your destiny. I don't care who in your family had what disease. There are things that we can do to make it much less likely or even highly unlikely or not likely at all that you are going to get this disease. So I think that's good for now. We'll move on to research in the next talk. The next talk coming up will be about the research that's being done about Stargardt disease.
All right. So stay tuned. That's coming up soon. And thanks for listening to part one.
Thank you.